The other day, we got a comment that was so uneducated about how CPTSD, you know, they go for a walk, it was a go for a walk style comment. And I'm just so pissed off with hearing them. Like, the people who say those things have not taken one single solitary fucking second to learn about the effects of serious fucking trauma-induced mental health issues, and it's just insulting to suggest that it could be something so easy as like a choice of how you think, or something so simple, just like, gee, yeah, thanks, I didn't think about that in all of my lifetime that I've been struggling to stay alive with these symptoms. Fuck off. So I managed to respond, like, I just responded how it felt natural to me, which was blatant sarcasm. And that felt comfortable, like, in alignment with who I am, defending us, not allowing somebody's distorted view of us to, like, make me feel the need to explain us or over-explain or, like, all of the fucking fawn mode related defenses that we were instilled with. I felt the parts of me that hold those feeling afraid, but they let me respond how I wanted to anyway. And that's happened a couple of times now. It's actually making me feel like more and more at home in the front of this body. Like, I don't have to back off or constantly respond in an unrecognizable way for our safety. It's starting to feel like I can actually have a fucking personality and exist as myself, instead of always having to compromise so that it feels like we won't get killed. And I really appreciate every part of me for letting me respond in a way I'm comfortable with. Yesterday was Mother's Day in the UK. No, the day before yesterday was Mother's Day in the UK. Yesterday / today, but my sleeping's been like all over the place, so it's confusing as fuck to track. And we survived it very fucking well, actually. There was a lot of grief, which I've still been being hit with today, and yeah, grief isn't on a timer, it's gonna hit me all days anyway. It's been rough. I've been getting a lot of memories of thinking back a lot to when we ran away from home when the body was 16. Like, remembering a lot of how I felt then and how similar in places the betrayal and the grief and the rage feels now. But instead of getting overwhelmed and splitting, I feel like I've just been feeling how we felt in small bursts, in manageable percentages, I guess. I've been sitting with grief in my chest pretty consistently sometimes for a long time, but I've been able to sustain it, and I've been able to sustain it. That's actually been exhausting and rough. It's been really weird and really intense integrating with parts of me that I know had had a really close relationship with our mom, albeit at points trauma bonded and meshed and conditional, because it meant rejecting so many parts of ourselves from such a young age. And still getting shamed and criticized, or dismissed, invalidated, or completely blanked if parts of us that weren't accepted tried for any real connection or were seen at all. Which, obviously, as those parts of me, it's very easy to be like, what the fuck, fuck off, absolutely fuck off. Especially with your, like, not addressing your own shit so that you can claim and think that you're not doing these things. You gaslight the shit out of us every time it happens. And repeatedly still do it, even when it's called to your attention that you're doing it. And it's intensive and strange to integrate with the parts of me that felt close, and to feel that, like, this image of what we saw her as, of the sort of relationship that we were told we had, but to see over and over again in joining the memory strands together that that's not what happened in practice for so many parts. It happened in practice, we were that close and we were a team whenever we were soothing her emotions or responding in a reassuring way to her, but that's not the response we got. And that's not even the response we got if we tried to do anything other than validate her. Even if we tried to say, where's that behaviour coming from and how must that feel, instead of just, yes, this other person is wrong, we'd get disapproval in looks, in blanking the sentence, in like looks of what seemed like disdain, in disconnected but then hostile, silent treatment-esque behaviour. It's really weird to see all of it at once, like all of that, and have parts of me going, but the mum we know would never do that, because we're a team, and because we're unconditionally loved, and all the things we heard, and all the things that were said, but then repeatedly in actions when it came down to it were never ever proven and were never what was acted on. But the parts of me that were told over and over again that we were loved unconditionally and that we were a team didn't see the behaviour that disproved it, because we'd switch. So now it's like joining them both together and seeing both of them. Something's got to break. And it's not going to be us this time, so it has to be the fantasy narrative. And it's like repeatedly seeing the suggested view of what she was like, which I see as all words, and then every time I remember an action that disproves it, it's like that image of her shatters, and that image of our life shatters, just over and over again. Repeated hallways of mirrors breaking. And I feel it like a similar pain in my chest, but without tearing me apart from my self now. spaces me the fuck out, because why wouldn't it? But it's disturbing, and it's distorting, and it's really confusing and really painful to be so confused and to realize that in these moments, seeing them before, they always got blanked, and our reality and our memory and our perception and us are the things that got pulled into question and shattered so that we didn't have to see it, where the reality would disprove the reality we were presented as the narrative, to instead see the narrative cracking and to see all of the behaviors of betrayal and self-serving behaviors that sacrificed us for her comfort, for the comfort of our abusers, that put her and our abusers before us over and over again and put us into danger repeatedly without any acknowledgement or attempts to protect us. Seeing all of that and realizing that all the times we've heard sentences like we're a team and we work together and we have each other's back and we're eternal, they were just self-serving fucking lies that I'm sure she believed when she was saying them. I'm not actually, I'm not even sure of that. I assume she believed as she was saying them and then just conveniently turned a blind eye against where it was a double standard. It was said and acknowledged when it was us looking out for her. But any time that she had to protect us, she'd just turn a blind eye to it. It's like all of the times that we were put in harm's way and betrayed and exiled in the parts of us who were, and then the other parts of us were gaslit, taught to self-abandon, taught to reject any part of us that had a problem with the way we were treated, taught to think that we were the problem through fucking scapegoating. All the time taught that this was not what was going on and gaslit. The parts of us that had a reality that was so shaky and distorted that it was impossible to trust our own judgment. And it's still a struggle to relearn how to do that. It's fucking harrowing seeing all of that together. Better to see all of that together than to be ripped apart so that I can see both things separately and never hold them at the same time, because you know how the fuck would you survive that as a kid if you could see it? It's really, really fucking harrowing to see and to be aware of. How much we believed in the false narrative of our as really being conditionally loved and unconditionally loved and unconditionally accepted and protected and all on the same side, and can really feel that, but it feels like a desperate hope. And I guess if it was ever real, it would have felt like security, which is a concept I am only newly coming to grips with. I think I can feel in some places sometimes. It's shocking. There's just so much reality distorting lies on top of reality distorting lies, all to hide abuse. And then we were taught so much that we were the problem, and that it's horrifying to think that we could think any of these things, because this isn't what's happening when it is all the fucking time.